On the previous video, we took a comprehensive look at Spider-Man's remastered graphic settings and performance. But there was one thing we didn't test. I'm talking about the three upscaling techniques supported by this game: DLSS, FSR 2.0, and IGCI. So today I will compare the quality and performance of each one across three different resolutions: 1080p, 1440p, and 4K. So without any further ado, let's get going. Now, I won't compare all options here. I will focus mainly on the top three modes: performance, balance, and quality, plus ultra quality for IGCI. And at 1080p, I won't test performance mode because it doesn't make much sense at such a low resolution, and the game is already CPU intensive. Using performance or ultra performance at 1080p will help your GPU, of course, but you will put more strain on your CPU, and I don't recommend it. And before we start, I want to talk about one problem with DLSS in this game. Normally, DLSS and even FSR have a sharpening filter in the render path, but for some reason in this game, the sharpening filter is set to a high value, which produces an over-sharp image, as you can see here. God of War before had the same problem, but they released a patch that added a sharpness slider, and I hope Nixies do the same thing here with Spider-Man. Another problem with DLSS is ghosting, which is noticeable in distant moving objects, like here with these moving ships. So take these problems into consideration during the comparison scenes. Now let's start with 1080p. Here we have balance mode between DLSS, FSR, and IGCI. Quality wise, you can see clearly that DLSS is better compared to FSR or Insomniac's solution. Performance wise, both DLSS and FSR are almost similar, but IGCI comes first with around 6% more performance than FSR and DLSS. Moving on to quality mode, it's pretty similar story here. DLSS looks less flickery and more stable, and FSR looks fine and less blurry than IGCI quality mode. But if we add IGCI ultra quality mode to the mix, IGCI comes closer to FSR 2.0, and that's also reflected on the performance side, with both IGCI ultra quality mode and FSR quality mode perform almost similarly, with around 1-2% between them. But DLSS gives around 4% more performance, and IGCI quality comes first with 5% compared to DLSS. Now, if we compare DLSS quality mode, which produces the best image out of the three upscaling solutions, against native TAA, you can see that at this resolution, DLSS looks better than TAA, and it will give you around 25% more performance. Now let's move on to 1440p. Here, similar to 1080p and as expected, DLSS has the edge on both FSR 2.0 and IGCI in performance mode. IGCI still looks blurry and doesn't reconstruct as good as FSR 2.0. Performance wise, and just like before, IGCI comes first, followed by DLSS with around 4% difference, and FSR 2.0 last with 6%. In balance mode, and I think you get the idea by now, quality wise it's the same as before. DLSS first, FSR 2.0 second, and IGCI comes last. But what's difference here is the performance. IGCI performs 6% better than DLSS and around 8.5% better than FSR 2.0. And last, at 1440p, we have the quality mode. And if we add IGCI ultra quality, we can see that FSR 2.0 quality mode still looks better overall. Performance wise, IGCI quality mode comes first, and DLSS performs better than both FSR 2.0 and IGCI ultra quality. And before we move to 4K, let's compare both FSR 2.0 and DLSS quality modes to native TAA. Here, DLSS looks cleaner overall, and FSR 2.0 might have more shimmering compared to TAA, but if we take a look at this tree here, we can see that it looks less blurry. And we can see that going from TAA to DLSS will save you around 25% more performance, and to FSR around 23%. At 4K, starting with performance mode, DLSS do a great job here, just like 1080p and 1440p before. And if we take a look at these windows here, we can see that FSR 2.0 managed to resolve more details compared to IGGI. But the performance at 4K is different. DLSS looks more demanding at this resolution and mode. While IGGI performs better with around 10% more compared to FSR, the difference to DLSS increased to around 19%. Balance mode gives similar results as you can see here. Performance-wise, this mode narrowed the gap between IGGI and both DLSS and FSR. We see around 7% difference between IGGI and FSR and around 12% to DLSS. In quality mode, both DLSS and FSR produce a good image because of the high base resolution. IGGI still doesn't look as good as the other two, and if we add IGGI Ultra Quality mode, we can see that FSR still looks better. When it comes to performance, unlike the other modes, FSR has the worst performance here, with around 15% difference compared to IGGI Quality mode. DLSS and IGGI Ultra Quality mode are similar, with around 7.5% difference compared to IGGI Quality mode. And if we compare both FSR and DLSS to native image, we can see that DLSS looks much more better than TAA. FSR must have more shimmering compared to TAA, but if we take a look back at these windows, we can see that FSR have more details than native. Performance-wise, going from TAA to DLSS will give you around 30% more performance, and to FSR around 20%. To conclude, DLSS implementation in Spider-Man left a lot to be desired. It suffers from ghosting and produced an over-sharp image. But the stability and overall quality of DLSS is really impressive, where even at 1080p, it managed to beat native TAA rendering. FSR 2.0 overall gives a much better quality than Insomniac's IGGI, which looks fine only when using the Ultra Quality mode. And we arrive at the end. Thank you so much for watching and for your time. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like, and if not, leave a dislike. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell for future videos, and I'll see you in the next one.